Not really.
Yeah, figured.
You're going to wait and see some of the guys around the court going to make a decision.
With Sylvan in particular, the medical guys told you anything about how serious or not serious that is?
I don't think it's serious, but it's nagging. You know, it's one thigh, then it's his knee, then it's the other thigh, you know, that sort of thing. So he's had a difficult time getting a good run because he always gets a step backwards. So we just want to monitor it as closely as we can. He's a young guy. He's got a long career ahead of him.
Coach, did you have any relationship with Willis Reed? Have any comments on his passing?
I didn't even know that happened.
Yeah.
No, I did not know him personally. Only, you know, in awe as a fan watching him as a player. He certainly was something special, but I did not know him as an individual. I'm sorry to hear that.
I guess Sandro was probably played more than he expected when he signed here.
Oh, sure, without a doubt.
What have you seen from him?
You know, he understands how to play the game. You know, he's a kind of a typical European who's, you know, been well coached and moves without the ball, understands how to, you know, change sides and the spatial relationships and space on the court. He's got good skills. He's a good athlete. I was very surprised. I didn't really know who he was.
Did you talk to Bud about him at all since he came
home? I did not.
Coaches, along with yourself, good luck on easily making the Hall of Fame soon. But in terms of Tony, he's expected to make it. What does he mean to this franchise, and why do you think the Hall would likely put him in?
Well, you know, he's been special, obviously, part of four of our five championships here, and obviously played a great deal in Europe in the summer times in between NBA seasons and been highly successful. So that all is pretty obvious, but for him to take over the program at the point at 19 and run the show for all that time is very special. I can still remember it was somewhere between 3, 4, 5 games into his first year that I gave him the ball and said, let's see if you can do it. And he just took off from there. So in that respect, he deserves a lot of credit for being able to handle that pressure so quickly for a team that was expected to do well every year. He's been a great teammate. He's been a great friend, you know, ever since. So I'm really thrilled for him to have this evening of joy and honor for him.
Did you feel like you had to be hard on him at first when he was?
Well, I needed to find out very quickly, so I threw him in the frying pan to see if he was going to be able to handle it or if he was going to melt on me, you know, so we got after it pretty good.
Have you ever apologized to him for some of the things you said to him?
No, I told him I made him a lot of money.
What do you think about all the stuff he's doing now? It's like he has his hands on.
You know, it's he's always been like that, though. Really, he can't sit still. He's going to this country, that country, for this business venture, and purchase this, give this speech here, travel with friends over here, and it doesn't stop. And he said, Pop, I'm going to be in San Antonio next week, you know, for 2 days or 3 days, and that's it. If you don't see him then he's gone for another 3 weeks doing something else. But it's who he is. He's always on the move. Okay.